Patnaik, India strategist at Mizuho Bank, also joins us on the phone line to discuss this. Tirthankar, would you concur with Adrian's view that perhaps this is a good time to be picking up the stocks that you always wanted to buy?
I would say that this is a good time to clean up your portfolios, build quality in the portfolio at 8,300 odd levels. The market still has downside to go. We have maintained that worries about China outweigh any that we have seen on Greece. And the current relief rally that we had seen since the Greek resolution over the last couple of weeks seems to be evaporating, as has been the investor confidence that the Chinese government's measures that were taken to stabilize the Chinese markets have gone off. So, you know, be prepared for some more pain. Of course, from a long-term perspective, and I mean over a 12 to 18-month perspective, we expect the markets to do well. And therefore, yes, this could be a point to clean up the portfolios.
Tirthankar, good afternoon. The problem is that quality stocks still remain quite expensive, and that they haven't corrected much except for cases like Sun Pharma, which are going through their own problems. So, you know, when you say buy quality stocks, anything that comes to your mind in terms of sectors or stocks?
So, like I said, which is why I said this is, I did not clearly agree to the fact that this is a time to buy the market. Please wait for more correction. And yes, you are very right in saying that quality stocks are expensive. You know, be it in the consumption space or be it even in the quality capital goods space, you have stocks which are trading north of 20 times their forward multiples. That is practically pricing in growth of, you know, nearly 8% this year, earnings growth of nearly 18 to 19% this year, while, you know, and of course following that with the same earnings growth figure for next year, about 17 to 18%. I guess that is where there is some sign of disappointment, some possible disappointment. You've seen FY15 as a low base will give you a good earnings in FY16, but FY17 might not. So I would say that from a sector perspective, rather than being positive, one should be cautious of certain levels. We have always, you know, been cautious on the cement names, on commodities names, global commodities names. So those are areas where we will be still worried even at this point, and we will hide in information technology. So that will be one area where we'll have differentiation across our portfolios and sectors.
Okay, you'll hide in information technology. Tirthankar, you know, it's interesting. All of the experts that we speak to, the FIIs that we speak to who are closer to the China region, don't seem to be as worried about the problem there as much as people back home. Do you think that we're just overreacting to the China problem as we did to the Greek issue?
My sense is that I'm no China expert, but I see the numbers in China and I see the extent of the fall in China. And the measures taken by the government in China, they tell us that the problem is not small. If the problem in China was something we could happily ignore and continue to remain positive in the long-term growth story of India, then we would not have had a case where about 1,400, 1,500 stocks were banned from trading. The people who had more than 5% ownership in Chinese stocks were not allowed to sell those stocks. We would not have a Chinese government agency being allowed to support the markets. We would not have had insurance companies in China having allowed to raise their equity exposure to Chinese stocks. If these are the measures that the Chinese government had to take to hold up the Chinese market, then I don't think it's a small problem.
Indeed. All right, Tirthankar. Thanks a lot for your time today. So that's the view from Mizuho Bank, that time to clean your portfolio and get into quality stocks. Let's